Kapitana Josephine Balusdan, Evelyn Balisong, Maribel Kagalawan, Manfred Binibli, Pangdaw Rimina, Magdalena Lambak, Roland Martos, Cayetano Edward Emmanuel, Joey David, Casimiro Castillo, and Susan Dondran. Oh, ngayon, good luck na kayo.
We thank you, Marot, TDIF. Anyway, they will be tawagan tayo suna, lukas ano. Yeah? Okay, the next speaker tayo, as I said, this is a very short and objective meeting. The next speaker tayo, kat na ito yung paborito tayo. Yeah? Ni Ma'am Betty Pangasan for the update on the all the concerns regarding City Social Welfare Development Office. And afterwards, if you have any question with regard to issues regarding the concerns tayo kung iso na, we can have an open forum right after she will update us. So, good morning, ma'am.
Okay, thank you, Councilor. So, first of all, I would like to say a pleasant morning to all of us. And congratulations, at least nalpas medyo, we are on going back to a normal situation after the highest peak wherein all of us are being called for na unfair, di ba? Ado, despite of what we have done, despite of all the relief goods, 120,000 na i-distribute tayo, o pwede 120 ka ng ibagama, thank you, awan pa niya. Despite of the 51,000 na insak tayo, i-interview tayo, where we paid 45,066. Awang pa'y kaming ibaga nga, thank you pa'y namin niya. Bunuan dan. Ayan na, siguro kurang. Dibagi, what is important, we are still here today. Hangkali, we are still here today. Awang din na COVID ganyan tayo. Awang din na kulong so far. What's important, we really have done our part. We were fast in responding to the needs of our people. That's how I assess it, because right now, dagijay ka na, yung namang disdisturbo ka na tayo, dagito yung isubsubli. Apay na may isubsubli, dagijay, because these agencies have been late. Late na may implementing program na, to the extent na those who had been bombarding us to be included, are now the ones again disturbing us to return. And by returning, they have to go through the same process. Mas naligbigat tayo isubli, because we had to cut out all the records going back. So right now, starting last week, all the subforms, payrolls, and everything are at the daycare center at City Hall. Nakalatag aming ijay, nakasla kami nga, looking for a needle in a haystack. No, kunada nga, daytoy inikan nyo, living alone. How could that be? Awan mo tinikikan tayo nga living alone, kisa. But when we went over their subforms, nakita mi nga sinadutang encoders. Well, you cannot blame also those who have encoded, because as a sabali di volunteers tayo. It's hard to control or go one by one and evaluate what they are doing. What we had before was full trust. Full trust, if itao nga umay nga tumultulong kada tayo, iso di jay tikas na nga nagkakaputan tayo nga everybody is doing his best to do what is proper. So di jay di apan bibirbirukan, nagi jay birth dates, nagi tuyhan ka nagibagay di birth date na. That's why we keep, good morning Mayor. This is the acknowledged presence of our city mayor, Benji Magalong. So those were the things that we have been doing, and now we are looking into those missing informations. Iso nga kunay siguro nalpasan. We are still going over those record because we have to upload complete data in preparation for the second issuance of SAP niya. So nagigay nag-isubsubli, still keep continuing returning ta adlaw nagigay nakaalam PSSS nga late. Just return it to the city treasurer because they had to follow a process on how to return those monies. So after that, after the issuance of this SAP, we have also closed our operation center, the relief operation center tayo. Because we have to follow through with what the city is going through in recovering. Alam mo na kanayon tayo nga aga in emergency, we are not. We can never go forward if we are not going to stop that. So what we have done after closing that PFBR, we operated Family Life Resource Center in every district. This is to answer the queries or the complaints if we hangalay ka iti relief, hangalay ka iti stop, and other issues. And at the same time, to visit the Ijay who were given these services but still in a critical situation in terms of meeting their needs like food. So my Family Life Resource Center, actually I posted that in our chat group, no, adilu na giting a Family Life Resource Centers in every district. Instead of 2016 na open. That is where you will assure that ito yung families nga who needs counseling, who needs to be assisted further, ure no nalpas na kijay relief operation tayo. And food for work is still continuing. Tatapay mo iti napagbati nga supplies tayo, although we have already set aside stockpile for succeeding no baka turun to, we have ensured nga dati supply tayo no sumangkot na kita na typhoon, ta typhoon season tayo mo tata. So we still have supplies. Actually, the other day, we received again a donation that was stuck by mayor from Lawag Chinese group. Yan, the Chinese embassy ba yun, mayor? So we have 2 tons. I want 10 tons of rice in the city engineer's office. And we will address those families na makasapul kun barangays who are in need of food for work. They have to do something before we give them these supplies. Nya, ang kalinga na pintas niya food for work? Okay. So we will still continue that. So, my sapay na function na ito yung FLRC, Family Life Resource Center, is to help you craft up a barangay recovery plan. Dapat we have to follow also in our own small community. We have to have our barangay recovery plan. Ado iti, kada kami bijay laong on relief operation and the social welfare activities. But you still have to include other concerns like bagita traffic, anya si recovery plan yung traffic, bagito yung jeepneys that Altea, that Attorney Tea had discussed a while ago. Incorporate those in your barangay recovery plan niya. So we told them to assist you in your recovery plan. It's always nice to document because it will help us in our future activities or operations. Lalo ijay data tayo ijay SAC and Form 200, we have found out lots of issues like adu ti unwed mothers tayo, adu iti live-in partners, adu ti prostituted women living in our community. What are we going to do with this? Adu iti children living in families not their own. What are your plans for them? Yeah, we have to ensure their safety, so we have to make use of those data na adakada tayo. Sayang na gijay nalipong tayo mga informations if we are not going to identify the gijay most critical cases nga dapat nga i-address tayo. Those are the things that we have to put in our recovery plan. Anyan ti plano yung kadagito yung ubinga na mapabuso gayang. Hanagay mga anak gijay, no wonder nga pabuso na. We have a case in Ambyong. They kunada nga nag-suicide, but not, no? It's being investigated. So, ano pa yung nagigay caring for children of their own, using them as their katulong. So, those are the things that we have to give priority nga ikan tayo kumati plano. And what alternative livelihood are we going to give kada kito yung abang ijay barangays tayo nga nagigay prostituted women ko na tayo man laungan. Di ba nagadado? In Pinot, I did not even know how we have 150 plus renting in that area. Nga, yeah? Itatakot awal trabaho na because closed that 30 bars, no? So what are our plans for them? Please help us identify so that Pagijay day tamada ka na tayo, hanglang basta nga matuturo. No? So we have to start from those forms. Oh, business, anya tikas tayo tanta ka, nagijay nakita yung adong agpapaabang. So those are the things that you have to include in your plan. So, as to SAP, we are still actually itataman yung deadline if we wait listed from FLRCs. As of Monday, ada pinakita ming 200 plus families who were left behind or they were included before but hangahin mabon when we had the one-stop shop. So those are the things that we are trying to process. And again, we will be going to the mayor, to mayor's office to have the proposal signed. Actually, namin duwa tayo nga nag-waitlisted, nag-submit tayo to waitlisted families. The first was the 1,422 and then the 137. But what affects us now is that ito'y agreed return niya. Yeah? They get to be from SS, from Dole. So let them return it to the city treasurer. They will follow the process of returning. While they get to i-process me nga families who are left behind, nga hantay mo na give attention or those who had been complaining and after assessment they are found qualified, we will still process them. So, our deadline, according to the SWB, as to the uploading, will be on June 15. So, hopefully, our IT school will be able to upload them. Kasi as of last night, 62 point something lang pwede na-upload, but according to school, ado pwede na-cleanse. So, once nga na i-upload aming DJI, 45,066, national agencies will cross-match iti da do mga ahensya like SSS, DOL, LTFRB, and all those who are giving social amelioration. And their deadline at the national level nga sapay kuma on the 24th of June, we will be receiving the second social amelioration on emergency subsidy. Actually, according to regional office, it's only Baguio Benguet who are included for the second tranche. The rest of the provinces are not because we were on ECQ then that time. The 30 medyo longer ECQ na. So, thanks to the mayor for coming up with a formula on asking nga, ito tayo pala nga state of situation. So, the rest, good, na GCQ na nga dagos. So, talagang awan. And it is really dapat because adumotel sa surface na tanga ko dagito yung pasyente tayuin niya dagito na COVID. So those second trans is expected on the third week of June. Hopefully, ma-upload ang amin ng DJ SAP tayo tapno ma-cleanse nga usto by the SWB. And as to the mode of distribution, they are still toying the idea of how to facilitate it. Like for instance, they might channel it to the M. Louvillier. That's why we keep on getting updating the cell phone number na giving a pamilya so that they will just call them, text them na your money is available at the Bayan Center or at the bank. You just bring your SAP form or your ID. So hang kayong makumpulitan whenever we ask you nga, anya ti cell phone number ni dito yung pamilya. Because they wanted to ensure na when they are called, they are the right people who will receive this SAP. And the names niya, dagijay nagnagan. Kasi di may sa maklinens tayo dijay, dagijay na yahan nga nagtugma dijay nagan na dijay ID from what was encoded. Wrong spelling po namon. So those were the things that we had corrected. Tapno kumpleto ti information. Dijay tiga po nga apay nga tayo ilinlinis, pati spelling, cellphone, how to validate it with the age of their children or birthday of their children. Mas damot ano, adati itawag na kanya yun. But those are the first information that they have to ask you. That is the reason why we are trying to cleanse our document. So hopefully on the third week, we will be able to access our second tranche. So with that, I would like again to say thank you for your cooperation. For the AX, it's a regular mga program tayo bigay. Aid to Individual in Crisis Situation or AX is a regular program in the City Social Welfare and DSWD. Well, di ba mo yung City Social Welfare katipan ng LGU? Hangkali. For additional AX, no naibos, no kurang, or naikan ka iti City Social Welfare, nga maalay ti pundo ti LGU, no kurang di jay, that's the time we have to endorse you, ijay, DSWD for augmentation. But that is for nagiti namatayan, nagiti agsaksakit, kung anya pa yung problema niya, nga talaga nga in crisis ti pamilya. Amo tayo mo siguro no anya, timakuna nga in crisis. That time awan po nos tipat, biru ka na, tikanin na, unong pang agas na. So those are the things that regular pa lang a program. Livelihood, still ongoing di jay. So hopefully, you will also identify families whose livelihood got affected during the COVID. Kata nga makaparwarman na iti capital na. Our office is giving 3,000 and above to individual applicant. 5,000 plus to family enterprise if members of the family are involved. And we can come up with an association for group of individuals or families who have the same project, and we can also coordinate it with DOL, DTI, and DOST. So regular DJ nga rami dun tayo. We are just waiting for the lag that comes from DSWD. Awan pa lang ti guideline na DJ livelihood assistant grant of 15,000. Awan pa lang. But we have to just look around from our community. No, sino nagidjay talaga nga small, medium enterprises na affected nga hang pa lang makarecover. Kati kaya tayo dijay small, medium, nagidjay nga employed ti babasit nga few people in his project. Nya like bakery, the community, hanin mag-operate, apay nga ta, sayang mo dyan yung mga employed na katanan nga trabaho. Those are the people that we have to recommend. Okay? So, just get in touch with your Family Life Resource Center social worker. Anya, tinusal tayo yung facility, daycare centers. Why daycare centers? Because they are not operating. And we wanted also our daycare workers, most especially the gifted parent committee paid, to have a continuous subsidy. Kano awan ti subsidy da, they will be again our problem. No awan ti swelduan da. They receive 6,000 pesos from the city government whenever they do something or activity in the community. Instead nga maawan trabaho na from June to August. Because the declaration iti DSWD, we will operate our daycare centers by September. Hopefully, dependent to di geno as ano ti sitwasyon tayo. But siguro with the cleanliness that we are doing, we will add up to the progress of our community. So with that, I would like to say thank you for listening. We are always at the Family Life Resource Center, the two unit offices, you know where we are. Just keep in touch with us for any inquiry or any assistance that our constituents in the community will need. Thank you.
Thank you, Madam. So, as mentioned ni Madam, if we have any inquiry or question regarding the weekly program at the City Social Welfare, you might as well refer to your unit, so that will be very objective today, especially in the announce na. Anyway, as to the Social Amelioration Program, second tranche, we just wait in Baganamat na ongoing pa lang the process na. Okay? So, before we give the floor to the mayor, may I call again the next 10 to prepare. These are the next 10 na bumaba. These are the 10 suspects niya. Oh. Ito, Fernandez Socorro, Kapitana. Elsie Magdalena Tindok, Ariel Dilmonte, Madam Edita Ibarra, Florida Gakayan, Margarita Marinas, Rico Dimumol, David Bayagan, Michael Marinas, and Arthur Carlos. Slowly you go down, tap noon tayo makoka for the rapid test. Yeah? Okay, so we proceed with our meeting. Now, today we will be hearing the message from our city mayor. Sir.
Ibagang sama tayo ako. I have a few announcements to make. First is Jay, maraming tayo tatang testing. And the reason for this is we'd like to really get the actual na situation tayo dito yung Baguio. Why is it that every time malpas tayo dito 15 days, 21 days at naman natin may sanga, makita tayo nga positive case. But the good news is, not unlike in the other provinces nga, almost every day, at the tirumuan nga, talo nga infected, 11 nga infected. Right now, La Union and Pangasinan, almost every day, at the tirumuan nga infection nga dyan. So this is something nga kikitaan tayo nga nalain. The good news is, instead of us spending 30 million to buy 10,000 PCR test kits, we were able to get more or less 50,000 PCR test kits without spending anything. So spending instead of 30 million, paala kayo nga dago. In fact, si Mampad Jai initial nga 10,000 and then there's another 6,000 that came in last week. Dapat iti 40,000 ngayon na PCR test kit. So we have enough. In fact, for the entire city of Baguio, supposedly, tima looking at the 1% na ma-test tayo. Because the standard is 1%. Here in the city, we can go as high as 10%. And that is what we're going to do now. One of the first step is, dito yung nararamid na tayo na rapid test kit. Ang kayo mandanagan, ang positive kayo, it doesn't mean nga COVID-19 kayo. Most probably, ang dala ang infection nyo. Tapos lang, hindi kanya. In fact, in my case, 4 times na ako nag-PCR at isang rapid test. Yung rapid test ko, nag-positive ako. Yung rapid test ko, pa-positive pa ako, present infection pa. So, huwag kayong kakabahan. No? Pag nag-positive kayo mamaya, malamang ano kanya yung positive ako. Positive kayo kan tatabi-tabi lang kayo ng konti dyan kayo masyadong magtatabi. Okay, anyway, mag-positive kayo, i-PCR kita kayo nadago sa niya immediately. You have to go on PCR and then you have to go on quarantine. Sino na natapos dito? Natapos na ako rito? At tinalpasan? At kayo ako? Okay. Sinabi na sa inyo ang resulta. Sino nag-positive na? Okay. In 15 minutes, you will receive. In 15 minutes. And then, slowly, at nag-positive kayo, then most probably, we have to do PCR with the entire barangay official. Also, we will also conduct either PCR or rapid test with Binaw and BHW. And then 10% also of our taxi drivers. Tatakat now daw at taxi drivers na i-test me. More or less 300 taxi drivers. And then another almost 5,000 na that drivers the PUJ. We will also again go back to the market and conduct another series of tests. Bijay market tayo. So we're concentrating on those people who are directly exposed to the public, especially the frontliners tayo. Our priority now is to make sure that our health workers will be safe and well protected. Isuda ti priority tayo. And our other frontliners, like our Binaw, BHW, our policemen, all these other volunteers, our social welfare, our social workers, we need to test everyone in their social welfare. So even in City Hall, my intention is to test everyone. So we have around 4,000 test kits and we will be getting more. We're not spending for anything. All of these are coming from friends who are donating. So that we will be able to maintain jay 30% ng calamity fund tayo. Ang tayo nga, we did not use it. we made sure that we're not going to use it. Because of the onset of the rainy season, if something happens, awanti mausap tayo. So we have money. If in case something happens, our 30% money is still intact. Including the 70% na calamity fund, it is still intact. Okay. So if something happens, we're there to really help you. At lang ti problema tayo na tackle. Hypothetical. Yeah. What if get hit with the calamity? We get hit with the calamity, and can you just imagine we have to evacuate people? When we evacuate people, yan na yung problema natin sa physical distancing. Yan na rin ang problema natin sa minimum health standard. We have to prepare for that. We need to prepare for that. So most probably in the next few days or few weeks rather, we have to put up the rigid plastic na walls in every evacuation center. Kasi kailangan natin pag-iwaiwalayin yung mga household, especially when we get hit. As much as possible, I encourage you to put up siguro 5 plastic walls each. Para kung sakasakali, maghiraman na lang tayo per barangay. Pwede tayong maghiraman. Anyway, you will only spend around, siguro mga per wall is around 1,000 pesos. We can provide, nagigay, kailangan yung akayo para lang maitayo nyo yung mga, para maghiraman na lang tayo. Kung sakali hindi kayo may, pahiram nyo yung mga wall nyo. I'll ask our CBAO to give you all the specific specification. So yun ang makiging nightmare natin pag nagkaroon tayo ng evacuation. So we have to prepare for that. Second is we have to prepare and make sure that we have enough water supply para dito sa Baguio. Meron nang namumuong Baguio ulit. And by weekend, baka tumamaraan dito sa tataas dito, aakyat na naman dito. And this month alone, we're expecting 2 more. So itong isa and then another 2 more na typhoon. And then succeeding month, kastamat. So let us all prepare for that. Now, there are questions about RBR. Ito yung RBR returning Baguio residents. So I'd like to emphasize, aming nagsubli na residente tayo ti Baguio, they have to register online. Okay, pag-register nila online, right now, we have a total of almost already 12,000. Ang naipapasok na natin is almost 5,000 na. 12,000 and adding every day. We're expecting about 20,000 to 25,000 RBR. Nung una, sinabi nila sa akin, sir, hindi pwedeng, oh, siguro baka 10,000. Sabi ko sa kanila, hindi. Aabot siya ng 20,000 or more. And true enough, ngayon pala, umabot na tayo ng 12,000 and more. We're averaging 298 RBRs every day. Ilan naman ang lumalabas? We're averaging 280 every day. Narumrumuan. Pero nakita yung narumrum market, almost 50% ang subsublida. So slowly, dumadami na naman ang population natin dito sa siyudad ng Baguio. So slowly, every day, we're making sure that we have adequate transportation for our residents. So at the number of transportation, we will add transport to barangays every market day, and that is special na additional, more probably average of 10 during market days. 10 vehicles. Yung ating mga jeepneys, provisionary, everybody, all the jeepneys can travel. It's just that, for example, one barangay, total number of jeepneys 100, pero ti-require tayo lang kanya dagat 30 or 40, the association will have to rotate them. Pero tuloy-tuloy pa rin ang inspection ng LTFRB and LTO. Ano ini-inspect ng LTFRB? LTFRB is inspecting yung roadworthiness. Anong ini-inspect ng LTO? Yung minimum health standard. So kung ang isang jeepney bumagsak, hindi na siya kasama sa rotation. So kailangan tuloy-tuloy na rin. No? We make sure that when we build back, we make sure that we will build back better. Hindi yung pag every time na may calamity, let us not follow other LGUs na pag nagre-recover sila, they're building back, hindi better. The system is worse, becomes worse. We don't want that to happen in the city of Baguio. Dapat mas improve yung mga sistema natin. So going back again sa RBR, lahat ng pabalik dito have to register online. No, the reason why madid-delay, the BJ approval tikwada, the application da is because they have not submitted the requisite documents. Ano na dito eh? Jai travel order or travel authority. Wala sila, may submit. They just registered. Kaya kung may mga kakilala kayo na naghihintay, it's because they have not submitted their travel authority. Requirement ng travel authorities, lahat. Anong requirement dyan is the barangay clearance and at the same time, yung health certificate. Dito sa atin, one-stop shop na lang. Our barangays, if you are not approached, yung mga constituents nyo, if they would like to get a barangay clearance or barangay certificate, all they have to do is go to our Liga ng Barangay sa ABC office. Doon na lang, lahat para settle na. Hindi na yung paikot-ikot pa, patravel-travel pa yung mga tao, kawawa naman sila. So that in that city hall, for example, nandyan na yung ABC, nandyan na rin yung health desk, nandyan na rin yung travel. Pero bakit natatagalan? Binago kasi uli ng DILG yung sistema. Dati-rate, city lang, okay na sa mayor. Pero ngayon, dahil marami naman kasi pasaway na ibang local government, can you just imagine, pati barangay siya nang bibigay ng travel authority. No? Ang gulo-gulo, ang ginawa ng DILG, hindi na lang, PNP na lang, lahat ang magbibigay ng travel authority. So kaya tumagal. In fact, unlike before, na pag nagpunta ka sa city hall, siguro pipila ka ng 1 hour, 1.5 hours, makakakuha ka na ng travel authority. Tatakot, mga lakatid, barangay clearance, kukuha ka ng health desk, kukuha ka ng certification from the local government, and then yung paper mo, maghihintay ka ng the following day pa, babalik ka uli sa city hall para kunin mo uli yung travel authority mo signed by the Philippine National Police. So mas complicated na, but we cannot do anything about it. That is the policy of the DILG. Walang problema sa atin, ang problema sa ibang local government. Kaya ganyan ang nangyari ngayon sa policy na yan. It's not the fault of the local government of Baguio. It's not our fault. Okay. Sa mga aalis na hindi na babalik, sana mas maraming ganun, no? Para mabawasan tayo. They have to go to athletic board. Doon lang, one-stop shop din doon. Doon sa mga multiple travel na pabalik-balik, city hall ang pagkukuhanan. Anyway, igagayin naman kayo doon. Okay, any questions dito sa stranded individuals, sa RBRs, at sa indispensable travel? Do you have any question? Wala na. Okay, our infrastructure projects. If you remember, IATF and DBM allowed us to use our development fund, the 20% development fund for COVID operation. I did not allow it in the city of Baguio. Why? because you need that 20% development fund in your project. Hindi ho natin ginalaw yan. So, ang tanong ko sa inyo ngayon, ang tanong sa akin ngayon, sir, ibig nyo sabihin, tuloy-tuloy yung project. Hindi natin ginalaw. Pero ang tanong is, sir, matutuloy ba yung mga projects? Probably yung iba matutuloy, yung iba hindi. Bakit? Bakit? Our funding, our appropriations relies on the revenue for this year. Yung inappropriate natin project na 2.255 billion na budget natin, it will still depend on our collection. In fact, doon sa projection natin, sa collection natin, mas tataas yung collection natin that was before the COVID-19. Pero with the onset of the COVID-19, we are losing around 38 million potential revenue a month. Hindi lang yan. Lumapit sa akin ang PESA, lumapit sa akin ang MOVE, lumapit din sa akin ang yung APAC na malalaking kampanya dyan. Again, they are also losing. Instead of around 200 million a year, and we are expecting dapat itong year na yan, around 220 million, swerte na kung makakolekta tayo ng 100 million dyan. Next is, yung mga revenue natin, very significant yung pagkakawala because of this COVID-19. In fact, for tourism alone, we will be expecting a loss of about gross receipt of about 3.7 or 3.8 billion for this year. Conservative estimate. Assuming na ang isang turista mag-i-stay lang dito ng isang araw. That's already 3.8 billion gross receipt. And if you translate that, yung 3.8 billion, ang katumbas nun is around 280 million pesos. So how much are we going to lose this year? We're going to lose around 400 to 500 million this year. So maapektuhan din yung ating development fund, 20%. So anong hiningi ko sa inyo? Itinuro naman sa inyo yung prioritization. For the meantime siguro, let us go for the 70% lang muna. Tignan nyo uli yung mga projects. Isipin nyo na lang na around 70% lang muna ang may implement. Okay, doon. So you have to prioritize. Do you have any questions sa infrastructure project? Now, yung sa DPWH funded na project naman, ang DPWH halos ang tinanggal nila is around 65%. Halos 65% ang tinanggal nila sa project natin. Now, in pinaglalaban namin, we met last Monday, we came up with our priority projects, hoping na ma-recover pa natin, at least, mabawasan lang, 35% lang ang mabawas. So, yun ang inilalaban natin ngayon. So, we're doing our best to get in touch with Secretary Villar para 35% lang ang mabawas, hindi 65%. Pero yung calamity fund na 300 million, ito rin, ang iniisip natin, nasaan na yung 300 million na calamity fund, hinahanap natin ngayon, baka kinakabahan tayo, baka pati yun na garnish para sa COVID-19. But we are still working on it. Next is, itong mga projects natin, na additional projects na funding, yung sa Burnham Park, totally wala na yung 480 million natin. Napunta na yan. Yung sa sanitary camp, pasensya na yung mga Batangay officials, sa sanitary camp, yung 500 plus million doon na upgrade ng ating sewage treatment facility or sewage treatment plant, na wala na rin yun, kinain na rin yun sa COVID-19. Okay. Mabuti na lang yung 200 million na cheque na ibigay sa atin noong November. So naitago natin yon para dito sa ating smart city system. Dito ilalagay yon. Itong floor na to, ilalagay yon. So 2 weeks from now, mag-umpisa na yung bidding process nun. Hopefully by August or September, umpisa na yung construction. Now, PPP projects. Tutuloy pa rin yung market modernization natin, the amount of 7 billion. Hopefully, before the end of this month, makakapamili na tayo kung sino mananalo, either SM or Robinson. Saka namin ipapublish yung design sa inyo. You will appreciate yung design because it is a green architecture and it is inspired by our local craft. Cordillera ang kanyang design. Okay. We will publish it. Tonight, at 6 o'clock, we will be meeting with Singaporean proponents for our monorail system. Yung train natin na system. They're very much interested pa rin na itayo yun. So we will be meeting with them. We will have a Zoom meeting with them, virtual meeting. Yung market will generate around almost 2,000 workers. 2,000 workers initially. 2,000 workers. Yung rail system will generate about 400 workers yan. Yeah, tuloy-tuloy pa rin ang yung integrated transport terminal. Sumulat na sa akin ang Mega World. They just finished the initial feasibility study. We're now reviewing the initial feasibility study. Yun yung ilalagay natin doon sa dairy farm. Tuloy-tuloy pa rin yun. It's another PPP project pa rin yun. And that would generate around 1,000 workers yung lugar na yun. Also, our waste to energy, tuloy-tuloy pa rin yan. That's the reason why yung PNOC keeps on coming up. Nagkakaroon lang tayo ng problema dun sa Pinsaw property. Kasi dalawa yung lugar sa Pinsaw ang tinitignan namin. May problema tayo dun sa claimants dun sa Pinsaw. Yung Youth Convergence Center, we will continue with that project. We still have the 150,000 peso. Yung flood control dyan sa section sa Burnham Park, that's around 190 plus million. Itutuloy pa rin natin yan. Yung road widening, madidelay yung funding yan, most probably 2021, road widening. So there are a lot of yung mga ibang projects ninyo ng mga protective walls, yung mga flood control, ipapublish ng public highways siguro within this month yung mga itutuloy na project. Isa lang ang hinihingi ko sa inyo. Please report to us yung mga anomaly sa mga projects. Report to us. I just would like to emphasize, we're not getting or we are not demanding a single percentage from the contractors. Ni Kusin, wala pa kaming dinedemand dyan. Kaya, ano yung project dyan, buong-buo na dapat pumunta dyan sa project na yan. Because once na humihingi ang mayor ninyo ng 10% o 15%, ang matitira na lang dyan sa project niya, 40% o 35%. It's not going to happen. Dapat buong buo, make sure na dapat quality project na pupunta dyan. I've been receiving reports from the other barangay captain of substandard project. For example, natawagan ka na kapitan, Leo, na-inspect na nila, na-correct na nila yung problema. And in the other barangays also, tumatanggap din ako ng mga report. Please do not hesitate to call me or to text me. I will immediately respond to your problem. Okay, yung peace and order naman, darating mamaya yung police natin dito para banggitin yung ating peace and order. Ang problema lang natin dito is yung rape. Please, monitor closely yung mga nakikita nyo na mga cases ng rape or sexual harassment or anything that would violate the integrity of our women and children. Please, closely monitor this. Take the case of example of a particular 7-year-old kid na pinalabas nilang nag-suicide. Ah, nakakita ng 7-year-old kid na mag-suicide. Only to find out pala na minurder yung bata. So we're now going to file a case against that couple. Muntik pa nilang itinakas yung bata, dadalhin sa Ifugao. Mabuti na lang, intercept. Inabol ng ating kapulisan. Another is, sino sa inyo ang gustong ilit ko yung liquor ban? Walang gustong magmalakas ng loob. Okay. Bakit yung mga counselor gusto nang ilit yung liquor ban? Bumay. Mabalihin kumagat hanggang MGCQ tayo, huwag muna tayo mag-lift. Nakita nyo siguro, yung tinarami di dyan, may isang positive patient natin. No? Lasing, nakipag-inuman sa Puliwes, taga-Puliwes. Pamilya nila, lahat. Yung inaawat ng tatay, yung tatay ang binumbo. Seriously injured yung tatay. Alam nyo ba kung anong ilang ang hinabol namin doon? Na contacts niya. Because he was positive for COVID-19. 94. Ang hinahanap namin na tao na contacts niya. So, mabuti na rin siguro na wala mo ng likor. No? Pag magiinom kayo, huwag na kayo maingay. Huwag na kayo mag-iingay. Huwag na lang kayo sa bahay niyo. Huwag lang kayo ma-report. So, yung SAP, we're going to... The good news is, merong dagdag. So please, please screen properly the applicants. I-re-release, i-re-release yung one. Siguro the next 10 days, magre-release na sila. Nakuusap ko si Kapitan Lea, si Ardileo, magre-release na sila uli ng second tranche ng SAP. So do you have any questions at this point? Last item that I would like to discuss with you. Please, closely monitor yung requirements po ng inyong mga residente when it comes to public transport. If you feel that you need to add additional PUJs, let us know, or taxis, let us know immediately para pwede tayo magdagdag kagad. Or all you have to do is get in touch with the association, jeepney association. Tuloy-tuloy naman ang aming pakikipag-usap sa kanila. Kung kailangan nyo ng dagdag, I will not hesitate to immediately approve your request. Huwag kayong mag-hesitate. Ang pinakaayon natin is yung pumipila yung mga tao dyan. This week alone, last week, 3 times ako umihi ko. 3 times a week. This week, yesterday was our 2nd time, twice, na nag-iikot ako. Making sure that our residents, pag bandang 5 o'clock na, 4:30 to 5 o'clock, hanggang 6 o'clock, dapat nakauwi na sila. Mabuti na lang, maraming jeepney kahapon na nakita ko sa mga terminal. Mahaba nga lang ang pila, pero at least nandun yung jeepney. Except for Luwakan and Quiaz. Kukunti pa rin ang lumalabas doon. Pero kunakno, when we met last week, Thursday last week, we were able to already to trash out yung mga issues. So around 14 lang pa lang yata lumalabas doon. Kapitan, dapat yung problema tayo ako, J. Quiaz? Okay na? So, Luwakan na po. Okay na, Kapitan Edward? Luwakan, okay na?
Okay, sir.
Basta na ada problema pa ikat. Huwag lang pilitin yung donation, tahimik lang. Okay. Ang sinabi ko sa mga jeepney drivers, huwag kayo ang mag-a-announce ng donation. Let the barangay officials remind the commuters about the donation. Okay lang yan. Tulong. At least may mas mabuting kayo ang nag-e-explain. Walang conflict of interest. So, do you have any questions, Apo? Yes.
Sige. May kapit, question ba?
The problem is, ipakdala mo.
Tapos yung panan, yung tinatap ko na pupunta sa baba, kung kaya natan.
Sir, yung how can we, sir, wala ko kasi yung guidelines on how to liquidate the RO fund and peace and order fund. Yun po yung problema namin, sir. Kasi gusto namin bigyan yung tanods namin ng benefit. Pero sabi naman sa accounting, wala pa raw guidelines po.
In behalf of the mayor, ganito kasi yan. First, yung sinabi ni Cap, yun yung pundo natin na nanggagaling sa anti-road obstruction niya. Yeah, share tayo. We have, di ba? We will talk again with accounting kasi tama rin yun. Wala pa yung proseso. Iayusin natin. Second, may I take this opportunity kasi meron tayong pondo, yung pinarealign ni Mayor na, if you remember, yung 3 point something million na din niya, na itad tayo kung matitanos tayo, we might as well talk with the Mayor and accounting, tabaka mabalin nga i-may-may sa tayo di ay, ta itad tayo nga kas na nga, we will review, if it's possible nga mabalin nga in the form of parang hazard pay niya, dagiti ay frontliners tayo. Maalala yun, di ba? Di 30,000, 29,000 na di. Nung awan pa iti guidelines na gusto. Yeah? We will take note on that. Tama yun. Buti na lang na banggit mo yung tungkol sa pan natin, sa share natin sa anti-road obstruction. Although nagagamit natin na yung iba sa pagbili ng mga gamit, ang question mo lang is, yung pwede bang ibigay natin sa mga tanods in terms of fund? Allowance. Yeah. We will take note of that. Anyway, we will inform the mayor. We'll discuss natin. Ada pa iba question nyo para ko di mayor? Lagi dating ang question, awanan? Ah, sige, teka.
Baru.
Teka.
Tiket pengadaman dan apumiu.
Okay, solve ko muna yung, kausap ko lang yung accounting ngayon para masagot kagad natin, hindi yung maghihintay pa tayo ng isang meeting uli ako. Kap, magtugaw kayo pa yung kap. Okay, ARO fund cannot be used to cover hazard pay. Very specific. Kasi if you look at the category ng how do you classify hazard, it's a personal service. So hindi ho pwede. Even if we will change yung executive order, it cannot still be used. It's a gross violation. It's a gross violation. So, pag-isipan nyo kung ano kaya yung pinakamaganda, because there is a specific purpose of the ARO fund. So, anong pwede nating itulong? How anong pwede? Pag-usapan nyo siguro sa legal.
Yes, sir. Actually, before kasi napag-usapan namin yan, na trust fund ang pupunta sa trust fund para mabigyan natin ng konting allowance yung mga tao. But I think we have to discuss with the accounting.
At the gamit yung inusap tayo ng honorario for the tanod. Pero intention is, if you can still generate funds para adati maitadyupay, kasi that ang basitan mo ti portamit na mitito tayo niya. Find a way. I have no objection. It's just that we need to really come up with the right term. Let's come up with the right term ako.
Yes, sir.
If you want us to talk, I'll talk with the accounting and COA. Para tingnan natin kung paano natin magamit yung pera para isuporta doon sa mga tanod natin. Sige, hanap ako ng paraan kung paano. Sige.
Thank you, sir. And on top of the ARO, yung sinabi ko sir kanina, yung
binigay natin na
29,000 or 30,000 per barangay, na that is for the augmentation of allowance to the tanod, sir. Yun na lang siguro ang ipon natin.
Pero mabaling ka na? Kapag-alaan tayo?
Meron na, sir. Nakadeposit na sa account namin. Pero yung guidelines lang ang one, ang kung paano namin gamitin. Kasi, ganito kasi yan, sir. Yung 30,000 per year per barangay, that is equivalent to 2,500 per month. Ang approved na po yun na po, Mayor, is the ang gamit nun is to augment the allowance of the tanods.
Okay.
Ngayon, ang sabi ni accounting daw, di ba ng accounting, hindi daw pwede na idagdag namin sa existing tanod. Ano yan? We need to hire additional tanod for the 2,500 per month. So nga, medyo conventional, hindi siya practical. But may rason kasi ang accounting that, of course, kung idagdag natin sa existing na sweldo ng tanods natin, maapektan yung PS, di ba? Mm-hmm. So nga, siguro sir, trust fund naman yun sir eh. Baka may remedyo na may kuha natin ng accounting at kuha lang.
So, kausapin ko ngayon. Yes, sige, kap.
Sige.
After this, kakausapin ko ulit si accounting kung paano. Para meron tayong
kreto sa mga. Dahil ayam tayo kumain sa barangay Duntugan. At di na panga
si Kapitan Mangkok na lockdown.
Bungkok. Dahil Duntugan ako. At di kaya ko kumain o mapalbalin. Dahil pati tubang ada yung abangkuha. Iso lang kumain may total lockdown. Dahil pag naanmod lang ti Santo Tomas Central, dito ayam kumod lang mo. At na mabalin, dahil station team ko makura mo, yung pindihayin. Kung may sapay kaya mga saludok, dahil nagay workers. Agkaradamag na no, anyati kastata, dahil jeep kat, pinasardom na amin, dahil jeep tinuntukan, hanta nga palabasin na. So nga, dahil ako kan, mabalin nga magnaga. Dahil lang ako mayroon.
Okay, before I proceeded to this meeting, napanaki jay operation center tayo jay temporary. Kinitak jay GIS platform. Adati pito nga contacts na jay site tayo. Ayan, Baguio. But before that, I just would like to inform you na nilockdown that Ituba side. Dugtogan Tuba was already locked down the other night pa, 9 o'clock. Nagdumtong kami ni Atty. Kukay. lockdown na yun. Kikita of the situation, the extent of potential na transmission, tiplano ko probably after lunch, I will only lock down group 7, 8, and 10. Baka yun lang ang ilalockdown ko sa Dugtogan, Baguio side.
Ang isang tanong niya, sir, because of Santo Tomas school area, they are passing through the Dugtogan area.
Where?
So, i-open time at lang siguro.
Where? I-announce ko mamaya. I-announce ko mamaya ako. Huwag ka mag-alala. Mandagagan ako. Yung Puliwes, Puliwes San Vicente. Mag-anood ni Kapitan Iba San Vicente na Major. Ang recommendation mo raw, extend pa raw. Kap, extend tayo ba eh? Pro-riot lang dyan, assessment ko. Pina-assess ko na ngayong araw na ito yung assessment. Pina-assess ko na yung Puliwes and San Vicente. So most probably this afternoon could malak dyan assessment. And then I'll make an announcement if you're going to be extended, including Puliwes. South Central, we are also doing an assessment, okay, South Central. Para at least we can already, you know, slowly transition from a lockdown to a normal. It will be announced today. So do you have any further questions? Meron ako, yes.
Thank you, sir. Jay, may salang concern me. Nakuha mo na dyan, barangay Milang or the whole District 3. Jay, namin quarantine pa, sir. Manipot, hindi namin saan nga andaw, hindi kang man kayo ang ganang tata. Ada dati pa subsubliin na nga yung J-Market. Tati, di ba, noong na kami nga District 3, no Monday, if I remember wrong, correct, from 12 to 6 p.m. and Thursday from 6 a.m. to 12, noon. Kaya di ba, nasukatanan 6 to 6. Nung manuti pinasubsubli na nga yung kapulisan tayo apo dyan, barangay nga pasuksukat na yung time. Kaya ko namin nga, understood saman yan. Diyan tayong kathanan. Tanay, busan kami, hindi ko. Bank paper, Apo Mayor. So, din lang, Apo Mayor.
Okay, sir. Kapitan Joe, ayos ko yan.
Thank you, sir.
Ayos ko yan. By the way, pinapag-aralan na natin na mag-transition tayo from 2 times a week to 3 times a week. Okay? Why? So that when we transition, it will be gradual. Gaminkat, saan mo't na mabalin nga from 2 times a week and then 6 times a week and then eventually 7 times a week. That's too abrupt na adjustment. So we need to transition from 2 times a week to 3 times a week. And then probably 6 times a week and then i-open tayo. Okay, so please prepare for a 3 times a week na market. Now, anybody who would like to object? Kapay may mayati 2 times a week langan? Or do you want 3 times a week? May mayati 3 times a week? Okay. No, ag new normal tayo ka, kaya yun 3 times a week pa rin? Well, mas slowly kuma. Na? What we're doing is slowly because of this infection. Just to give you an idea that we still have 36, 5 are still in active tayo. At dati may sanga kaso tayo dito. Di our record is 44 days na positive isuna. The policeman, I believe, will probably break that record. 5 times na siyang nagpa-positive. Tuloy-tuloy pa rin, positive siya, positive. Sana, hopefully, this week, lumabas na siya. Kaya lang naman siguro siya nagpa-positive dahil iniisip niya siguro na pag lumabas siya, may kaso pa rin siya. Pero inayos ko na. Kakasingat. Natutong ko ni Chief PNP, sabi ko, tanggalin niyo na yung kaso niya. Kawawa naman. Nag-suffer na yung bata. Tapos yung wife niya, nasa Palawan, also as a frontliner, as a medtech. So, patawarin na lang. Okay naman. So, hopefully, magkaroon na siya ng peace of mind. Kakasin mo. So, we still have two cases. One in Tuba and another in La Trinidad. The problem is, all these cases in Benguet, we are always affected. Almost 50% to 70% the contacts that is still in Baguio. So we're not safe. Kaslamo di may sana prison guard na si Mampet, taga Itugon, he was only sent here to escort a prisoner, only to find out na pagsubli na, ay before he left, tinest natin, nag-positive. Pero yung infection niya, nakuha niya sa Bucol. So, pasensya na ho kayo. If you are asking, when will the MGCQ terminate? I personally, looking at our present situation, I won't even recommend that we terminate MGCQ by June 15. Nagpasensya kayo ako. But we will slowly transition to a 3-week. Every Sunday will still be a Senior Citizens Day, including a senior citizen, a grandpa or grandma day. So they can be accompanied by the video ubing. Yeah. Second is, this coming Sunday will be a day for special kids. So they will be at Burnham Park and we will provide them that itod mga food packs kanyada. So please allow the video special kids to leave and go to Burnham Park. Takasi damatan, nagdagat nga, nang imatuti anxiety level dan. So I have no further announcement. The Vijay peace and order. Dumating na ba yung officer nyo, operation officer? Ulit kayo, para makilala ka nila.